The main library of San Francisco is a very special place for Pinoys, especially because of its Filipino-American center. It's an entire section filled with books and other media all about us. Well, this summer, there's another reason to love the library because Bren Bataclan is back. Naalala niyo naman po si Bren Bataclan, nakasama natin siya dito in our tambayan. And for those of you who missed it, he's the world-famous artist who has brought smiles to faces all across the world with the caricature-like paintings of his art project, the Smile Project. Well, this summer, he's back in San Francisco with a new exhibit called Baha, and Karmina is there to check it out.
Hi, Bren.
Maraming salamat for having me back.
Nice to have you back. Now, itong Smile Project paintings, tuloy-tuloy pa rin to, correct?
Tuloy pa. I just left paintings here at the library.
Nandito po ta kasi tayo sa San Francisco Library na merong exhibit po si Bren Bataclan. It's sort of bittersweet because your takeoff point for this whole exhibit is something so devastating. And yet, pag nakita mo naman yung artwork, you have no other emotion to feel but hope.
Yes.
And perseverance.
Yes.
Tell us about your exhibit called Baha.
Last fall, after the flood happened, I felt really helpless. And so what can an artist like me in Boston do to like help out? You know, goal ko, it's like try to find a way to like help out. Meron kong exhibit doon, initially it was supposed to be about Voltes 5. And how those robots have helped my artwork. And then the last minute, I asked the gallery if I can change the topic to the flood-related exhibit. And they said yes. And then I spent months looking at news photos and videos based on the flood. And so I interpreted the news photos into these paintings. So this is my first kind of figurative and narrative painting series, because most of my paintings are just cartoon characters instead of headshots. This is full figured, you know, with hands and feet, facial expressions.
So you spent the first 12 years of your life actually living in the Philippines.
Yeah.
So alam mo yung ganitong sitwasyon.
Alam mo talaga, yes. Yeah.
So parang looking at all these pictures again.
Yeah.
Parang brought back memories of your childhood too.
Yeah, because one of my fondest memories of the Philippines was when I was a kid playing out in the rain. But hindi bumabagyong this much, you know.
Kasi nung mga bata tayo dati, di ba? Parang masarap sa atin pag umuulan. Kasi number one, walang pasok.
Walang pasok. Siguro number five, remember? And our old neighborhood go, yeah.
Walang pasok. Yeah, tapos maglalaro tayo sa baha. Tapos champurado lang yung kakainin natin, di ba? That's the best. Now, tell us about how you transitioned from your babies, your characters, to full-figured characters. Kasi medyo, if you look at it closely lang, dun mo makikita yung signature Bren Bataclan.
Yeah.
But then from afar, you kind of have to think twice if this is really you.
Yeah.
So how did you, was it weird all of a sudden that you had to put legs and arms and hair even to some of them?
Like it came out naturally. It was something that I needed to do because this is my seventh year painting now. So I guess it's just a natural evolution. Then slowly, like if you look at my characters, they have started to like sprout hands and feet, some of them, but still most are just faces. And so these are natural kind of like occurrences based on my characters. I looked at a lot of photos of human beings and Pinoys, and so I started to render them as human beings. Someone accused me all of the guy's hair look like my hair. It's
I
look at
wisps,
that person
man.
All the time. And so it is also great to like paint us Filipinos.
Right. Bren, was there ever a point in your whole creative process wherein you were kind of concerned about trivializing the whole devastation that happened?
Oh my God, talaga.
Through your artwork, because you don't want to make it too cartoony.
Yes.
Tell us more about that.
Mahirap, dahil my work is known as being kind of whimsical and fun, and not that kind of serious.
Right.
And so I have to have a perfect balance between cartoon and also real life situations. But once again, hindi masyadong struggle, it just came out. One thing I wanted to show is the hope and resilience and us helping one another. Mm-mm. And even though there were thousands of cars destroyed, to have that character saying these are just objects.
Right.
Like my life is more important and my family and all of that. Mm-mm. It was also hard to determine which characters will have the smiles on their faces. Mm-mm. Versus no expressions at all. Mm-mm. So the faraway shots of have no facial expressions. Mm-mm. But the ones that I have closer, I have either a smile or like an expression of kind of like, you know, determination.
Mm-mm. So some of these pictures actually most of these pictures have real life pictures as their pegs.
Oh, katulad ng
nabanggit mo kanina. Yeah. What made you decide to get these pictures as inspiration and discard the many pictures of the terrible, terrible devastation?
Wow. Well, most of the ones I've chosen are the best photos and the most popular one. And so these are mostly of news photos, of professional photos. Mm-hmm. And it's a big difference between someone with the cell phone and someone whose life is taking photos. Mm-hmm. And so most of them are the ones that have been used by newspapers and TVs, mga ganun. Because you're right, there are thousands of photos. And I looked at hundreds of them. Mm-hmm. Over and over. Mm-hmm. And over again. Mm-hmm. And these are the ones that I have naturally kind of honed into. Mm-hmm. And I intentionally painted the characters yellow.
I see. And so may political commentary pa pala dito.
Uh-huh, yeah.
So, okay.
And folks, non Pinoys asked me, how come they're all yellow?
Uh-huh.
And so I am glad that I have that chance to share that.
Oh, because later on, years from now,
yeah,
when people see these pieces, at least there's a peg in the history of the Philippines,
yeah,
that this was a time when change was apparent in,
yeah,
the country. At linagay mo din dyan.
Yeah, and it wasn't really planned because I didn't know that he was going to be the president.
Right.
And this piece has our flag.
The
yung
colors,
sun, the three stars, and these are what makes the flag.
I think out of all the pieces here,
yeah,
this is the one that I can resonate with the most.
Yeah.
Kasi talaga, it's right there. It gives you hope.
Yeah.
It gives but it also shows you perseverance.
Yes.
And the fighting spirit of the Filipino people, yeah, despite adversity.
Despite adversity, yeah.
Hindi ba?
Yeah.
So, looking at these paintings, we just want to know what's next. Kasi gusto pa namin malaman ano pang gagawin mo.
As soon as I get back, I will paint a series of paintings of animals that have been affected by the oil spill. Mm-hmm. Medical New Art Studios of Boston. Mm-hmm. And that's how I will throw the party for it. Tapos, I will paint a billboard in Michigan. And after that, I will have a show in Salt Lake City.
Amazing. So, so many things to look forward from Bren Bataclan. Nako, kapamilya, abangan-abangan natin to. And we should follow him on Twitter, right?
Yeah, Twitter.
Ano ang iyong...
/smileproject.
Ayan. So, maraming salamat for joining us. And
thanks,
we look forward to having
back.
You back. Thank you for making
Thank you.
Us so proud.